The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. Jesus called the 12 together and gave them power and authority to overcome all demons and to cure diseases. He sent them forth to proclaim the reign of God and heal the afflicted. Jesus advised them, "Take nothing for the journey, neither walking staff nor traveling bag, no bread, no money. No one is to have two coats. Stay at whatever house you enter and proceed from there. When people will not receive you, leave the town and shake its dust from your feet as a testimony against them." So they set out and went from village to village, spreading the good news everywhere and curing diseases. My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Let us look at the different ironies in life. At 40, it doesn't matter if you are educated or uneducated, because some people who failed to finish their college degree, some of them were richer than those who finished. It is what you do with your life, not what you do with your diploma. At 50, beauty is no longer important. Everybody have wrinkles. At 60, when people begin to retire, you begin to understand that respect is not about possession. The moment you retire, the people under you, if you are bad, you will never be respected. At 70, big house or small house doesn't matter. Why? You have fewer steps already. Sabi nga ni Cardinal Rosales, pag matanda ka na, wala kang sakit, pero lahat masakit. Darating yun. At 80, it doesn't matter if you have money or without money. Why? You do not know where to spend it. At 90, it doesn't matter whether you sleep or awake. Kasi hindi mo na alam kung gising ka o tulog. Yung iba, pagkagising, tutulog na naman. Look at the ironies of life. The first reading of today is a continuation of the first reading yesterday. What was the first reading yesterday? Grace, like water, seeks its own level. If you pour water, it seeks its own level. The same with grace. You don't simply pray for grace. You have to live a life so that grace will come to you. As St. Thomas of Aquinas have said this, grace builds in nature. You cannot force grace to anybody. You have to live according to the nature God has given you. The opposite is the same. Cursed or karma comes with those who failed to live according to the grace. What is the gospel trying to tell us? Ask yourself, what is really more important? What is really more important? Do not forget that there are more important things than what your hands can hold. There are more important things than the position you can hold. Alam ng marami yan, alam ng kaparian yan. Pag batang pari ka, ang tanong lang naman, saan ka naka-assign? Pag medyo middle clergy ka, ang tanong, anong project mo? Anong pinagagawa mo? pag ikaw ay senior na, isa lang ang tanong sa kapwa pari, ano na ang blood sugar mo? Maintenance. Darating at darating. That's why it's good to remind ourselves that our goal is not to live long, but to live well. What prevents us from living well? We tend to believe, like last Sunday, that to be great is more important than everything. We want to be great, we want to have more, because we tend to believe that we will be loved by more people if we have more. As I always say this, if people loves you by what you have, then you are not really loved by people. You are loved by what you have. The moment you lose you have, the love you expect will be lost from you. Think about it. I've been sharing this lately because you know that I had a stroke 2 years ago. Then it gives me a deeper understanding of how we can appreciate health. As I always say this, if you have 100 problems, the moment you get sick, all your problems will be gone. And you will only have one problem. And that is health. If you don't have money, if you have pool of money, if you are sick, the same. The same. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, focus on the essential. Focus on the essential. Sometimes we clutter our lives with so many things. So many things. Even in pilgrimage, we try to think of what to buy. We try to think of anong pwedeng pasalubong. Ano po? Huwag niyong problemahin yan. Problema nila yan. Ano po? Mahirap yung umaasang may pasalubong, wala namang pabaod. Di po ba? Don't pressure yourself in those things. My dear friends, you don't go on a pilgrimage to buy for people. You don't do that. You seek a moment of encounter with God. Mahirap yung matatapos yung pilgrimage. Nakasalubong ba ang Diyos? Ay, nakalimutan ko. Sayang. Sayang. Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord. Sa gospel, pinaalala lang ng Diyos sa kanyang mga alagad. Heal the sick. Heal the sick. Perhaps, if there is one thing I personally ask God, that I'll be an instrument of healing. An instrument of healing. Kasi, kahit mayaman ka, pag may sakit ka, wala naman talaga. Hindi po ba, ano? Hindi mo alam kung kailan ka magkakasakit. Huwag mo ipagdadasal na magkakasakit ka. Hindi ba, ano? Paalala nga ni Raquel kanina, lakad na walang humpay mamaya. Hindi po ba, ano? At alam ko, ang iba sa inyo nag-iisip, sasama pa ba ako? Hindi ba? Pero sigurado ako, kung papipiliin kayo, Vatican Museum or shopping, shopping kayo. Pag tiningnan nyo yung steps na gagamitin nyo sa shopping, sa Vatican Museum, mas mahaba yung steps ng shopping. So, hindi yung lakad ang problema. Ang problema ay priorities. Inuulit ko, hindi lakad ang problema. Ang problema ay priorities. Learn to ask for the grace of knowing what is essential. Sabi ko mga kamakailan, ano bang essential pag umuulan? Payong. Yun lang naman, di ba? Anong essential pag ihing-ihi ka na? CR. Kahit may sale dyan, hanapin pa rin CR. Diba, ano? Know what is essential. When everything is being presented before you, do not be deceived, but focus on the essential. The essential is not what, but who. Who is the essential? Do not forget, Jesus is the reason. Amen. Again, brothers and sisters, do not forget what is essential. We don't have the luxury of time. Minsan, binati ko po ang isang retired bishop. Sabi ko, Bishop, kumusta ka na? Ang tanong niya sa akin, Bishop ba ako? Sabi ko, opo, obispo kayo. Saan? Nako, tapos na. Hindi po ba, ano? Lilipas lahat. Ano pa? Malilimutin na rin ako eh. Tinatanong kong pangalan. Pangalan mo, Father Tony. Father Henry. Tama ba? Oo. Father Richard. Ano nga pakala mo? Lahat ay lilipas. Seize the moment. We don't have the luxury of time. As I always say this, if you have everything and you don't have Christ, you have nothing. Let me repeat that. If you have everything, but you do not have Christ, then you have nothing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks.